In 2012, Facebook ran an experiment on 1 million of its unsuspecting readers, whom it divided into two groups of 5 lakhs each. One group received only happy posts from friends, the others sad ones. They wanted to see if they could manipulate you into feeling happy or sad. Guess what? They could. The recent Cambridge Analytica scandal is a continuation of this manipulation. In the US elections, they use these tactics to discourage voting by voters of a particular party.
Hey man, I gotta go vote. Looks like my candidate is gonna win anyway. Okay, I can skip voting this time.
It all started with a simple quiz placed by researcher Alexander Kogan, who then directed you to his website and asked for stuff about you, like your Facebook profile, friend lists, about you, pages and posts you like. If you said okay and 270,000 did, within seconds Kogan had access to 87 million Facebookers, 40% of Facebook's 2.2 billion global audience. This data was later sold to a firm called Cambridge Analytica, who are big daddies in analyzing big data.
We can bypass logical thinking and appeal directly to people's emotions, thanks to the 4,000 to 5,000 data points we have on every single US citizen.
What are data points? Every post you made, what it said, whether it was a happy or sad post, its location, time, language, tone used, every post you liked, what type of story it was, political, religious, human rights, environment, tech, sport, which team, which player, right down to the last detail. Advertisers have for years used demographic profiling to sell their products. Demographics assess basic things like your age, your sex, where you live, if you own a two-wheeler, a computer, etc. Take this example of the demographics of a typical T20 enthusiast versus that of a gamer. But till now, nobody has been able to analyze how people think and to take a deep psychological dive inside your mind. People don't realize what breadcrumbs they leave around the internet. Cambridge Analytica uses an algorithm that spiders through your Facebook, which within seconds analyzes all your data points and spits out your ocean tendency test score based on the following parameters. O for openness, how open you are to new ideas. C for conscientiousness, if you are the kind of person who fulfills their responsibilities. E, extroversion, is your nature friendly, whether you make new friends easily. A for agreeableness, whether you can influence others or do you follow others' opinions. And N for neuroticism, how far you will go to do things your own way. Donald Trump's team created a 220 million person database nicknamed Project Alamo, which contained details from passport, credit card records, car, gun ownership, etc. They used a combination of ocean and Alamo, mixed it with artificial intelligence. Then, using Facebook's lookalike audience features, they created groups of similar people marching to the same tune. You've heard of identical twins? These are called statistical twins, drenching them with targeted ads of what they wanted to hear, also known as fake news. At the peak of Trump's campaign, on a single day, they placed a mind-boggling 175,000 ads, each with different messages to different groups. For example, this could be happening right now in India. One group of people who are anti-Salman would see this story.
Justice prevails. Salman Khan finally gets a jail sentence.
While another would see an altered story with this headline.
Salman Khan jailed for killing deer while human killers roam free.
When people are purposely fed only one side of a story, they cannot see the other point of view, leading to disagreements and fights. The difference between the video platforms of YouTube and Facebook is that all YouTube viewers can see the same video, whereas on Facebook, everyone can be shown a different video because Facebook is personalized to each user. Of its 24 crore users in India, only 335 people were directly affected due to the data leak. But those 335 people had a combined total of 5.5 lakh friends, all of whom could also be affected. Facebook has already collected all your call data records and your entire phone list. In India, it is a crime to collect this information without permission, which alas, you have already given. See Bisbo's story on the CBR scandal. In March 2018, a whistleblower shocked the world when he deposed before British parliamentarians.
Cambridge Analytica helped cheat Brexit votes and the US election.
Channel 4's sting operation found that Cambridge Analytica had mined Kenyan voters' data to help President Uhuru Kenyatta win elections. Colombia, South Africa, Italy, Indonesia, Malaysia, and Thailand are other countries where Cambridge Analytica have worked in national elections. For very long, Facebook refused to accept any wrongdoing, but faced with threats of lawsuits, replacing Zuckerberg, or breaking up Facebook into smaller, more manageable companies.
We didn't take a broad enough view of our responsibility, and that was a big mistake. It was my mistake, and I'm sorry.
Facebook shares dropped 21% from their peak since the scandal broke, due to the possibility that they may be forced to change advertising policies and from lawsuit penalties resulting in lesser profit. So how come Facebook is free for you and me, and still they make a profit of $20 billion or 13,000 crore rupees? They must be selling something. They're selling us. You and me are the product. We are being sold. Most of the compromised data is through Android. iOS phones are safer. We could make a ton of money if we monetize our customers. We've chosen not to do that. Despite all this, what they have done, though morally reprehensible, is not illegal. According to the Internet Standard of OAuth, this is not a data breach. Open authentication is a standard where smaller apps use the authorization infrastructure already available with internet giants like Facebook and Google. Unlike strict EU laws on data privacy, India has only released draft guidelines and are still struggling over Aadhaar.
People in government don't even understand big data and how it works, so they cannot even make effective laws to control it.
Recently, the hashtag Delete Facebook movement started by WhatsApp founder Brian Acton saw Elon Musk, CEO of Tesla, deleting his Facebook account. In one of Bisbo's earlier stories, we had shown opposite views on artificial intelligence given by Elon Musk and Zuckerberg.
Artificial intelligence is an existential risk to the human race.
These are doomsday scenarios. I think AI will improve the quality of life.
Cambridge Analytica used AI under Zuckerberg's nose, proving Musk right. But with almost no way to stop misinformation, aka fake news, from spreading, how much more sinister can it get? Bisbo's Limerick. We give away our personal data for free. We say, what's the harm if we agree? But here's the catch. Marketers mix and match, dividing us into groups just to make us more angry.
All our videos are based on news and information published in leading international newspapers, magazines, professional journals, and news channels, which we present in a fun and interesting way. We pride ourselves in being a source of authentic news.